Dan Cantor had a philanthropic spirit that was unbounded. He loved to help people. He wanted to make life better for many, many different groups of people. Dan's spirit was as big as a mountain, and he was a mountain of a man. He gave. Anybody who came to him and asked for help, he gave. He was a very, very lucky, successful businessman. National Parkinson Foundation came to Daniel through a mutual friend. He met Mr. Slewitt, and they became very, very close. They were on the same page with their philanthropic endeavors, and Nathan was a vibrant man in his own right, and we grew to love him. And Dan and he got along just beautifully. And the fact that his mother most definitely had, or we presume she most definitely had, Parkinson's disease, this was something that came close to him. That is the link to Dan's philanthropy to the National Foundation for Parkinson's. There were two sons, and then Dan was a twin. So there were three boys and Miriam, the twin sister. Whenever the family went to a function, a dinner dance, things like that, the boys always danced with their mother before they danced with their wives. She was the matriarch. My favorite thing about Dan, I think mostly I like the twinkle in his eyes. He had really nice eyes. He had blue eyes, and he smiled a great deal. He was a happy man, and he just gave forth with a lot of power, and he was just such a good man. We married in the year of 2000, June of 2000, and we were happily married 10 years. And in June 14th of this year, Dan passed away.
What the world needs now is love, sweet love. It's the only thing that there's just too little of. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. No, not just for some, oh, but just for everyone.